All right.
It's fine. Okay? It's totally okay. Don't freak out. What's up, you guys? Welcome to another episode of Hair Goals. In today's video, I'm going to be telling you all the tools that you need to do your own hair extensions at home, or if you're going to be doing it on somebody else, pretty much everything that you need. Really quickly, I just want to say it so that I get it out there, because otherwise I'm going to get nervous and not film this video. So I put together a hair extension kit, basically everything I'm going to show you guys today. It's on my site right now if you want to check it out. It's going to be linked in the cards above as well as in the description box below, and at the end of this video, if you want to just purchase everything in a one-stop shop and support a small business, you can. If not, you can also go to Amazon or your local beauty supply store, wherever you want to go, and purchase pretty much all these same things. So let's just get started. What are the tools you're going to need to do your own hair extensions? The first thing, which is probably the most important, and mine tends to walk away, so I have like a bunch of these on hand, because like I said, mine walk away in the house, which is really crazy because I'm the only person with long hair. So it's like, but anyways, so you need a metal tip comb. I would not recommend getting the plastic ones, just because the metal tends to give you a straighter part, which is exactly what you use this for, is to get as straight of a part as possible when you're installing your extensions. A lot of what causes the breakage when you put hair extensions in is if you don't part your hair correctly, or you do like a messier part and you end up pulling hair from another section, it can tangle up and cause breakage. So you want to get a comb that has a metal tip on the end of it so that you can get very straight parts. Next comb that you want to have is, this is just a personal preference, I don't like any other comb for combing my hair and styling my hair except a rake comb of the sort. So this one right here is mine of choice, but I just prefer this for when I'm trying to like style my hair and detangle it. It works really great when you're in the shower because it's very wide, so you're not worried about tangles and ripping your hair out. It also works, like I said, for me for styling purposes, so I do like this type of comb. Alright, so the next styling tool that you would need, or that I would recommend, is a brush like this one here. So this one is pink. The original one that I had at the very beginning was black, and I got it from Sally's for I think like $15 or something. It was crazy, but I love these brushes because they don't tear your hair. You don't see as much breakage with these types of brushes. It's technically considered a wet brush or a detangling brush, but I really like it just because the bristles are very flexible. So instead of when you're brushing your hair, it's not going to rip it out, it's just going to kind of bend with your hair so that you don't tear it out. So I definitely like these brushes here, especially when I have extensions in, but also with my natural hair as well. The next two things I would recommend are butterfly clips, especially for, honestly, you guys have seen these in probably all of my hair extension videos as well as my hair styling videos, because these are multi-purpose. I use these for separating my hair out when I'm styling it, and also when I'm trying to like just part my hair off for extensions. Typically when I'm still doing my hair extensions, I will section off like one whole section, and then I'll do a subsection of that. And so the subsection one I'll use this for. Then the other tool I would recommend are alligator clips, and these are for when you're doing even smaller sections to kind of get all of the little baby hairs out the way so that you get a completely clean install. I recommend having some alligator clips on hand just because, like I said, you really want to prevent tangling and just a mess. So I recommend alligator clips. Last thing that I recommend are hair ties. I like these right here. They don't have the metal on the end of them. I tend to get the ones that are made specifically for thick hair, but really you could use any of them. I like the ones for thick hair because they don't break as easily on me, especially when I use them on like my braids and that sort of thing. But I also use them for actual like my hair extensions as well. Alright, so the last thing you want to have on hand is a extra large or extra long bonnet. I love these for when I have braids in my hair and when I have extensions in, because typically I go for the 18 to 20 to 22 inch extensions. So I really like these just because I feel like it just protects my hair. I can braid it down and then just throw this on, and it does have a elastic right here. The elastic could be a little tighter, I'm not gonna lie, but I just think I just have a small head, so that's why it's not super super tight on my head. But I do like this, and they actually come in two colors. So there is leopard print, because I'm just kind of into leopard right now, and then there is the basic black, so you do have that option there. But yeah, that's everything that I would recommend having on hand and when you first decide to start using and wearing extensions. There are a couple of different things that are specific to the type of extensions you're going to be installing. So for tape in extensions, you should probably have a remover on hand, especially if it's your first time, because if you mess up, you don't want to have to rip your hair out trying to take one out. Trust, okay? If you have if you're going to do micro loop extensions, I would recommend having some pliers on hand. These aren't included in the kit. This is another section. So I would recommend having some pliers on hand, just because you need to be able to close the beads. Thankfully, with micro loops, they are pre-looped beads, so you really don't have to have anything except just the pliers. But if you're going to do micro link extensions, which I've also done here on my channel, you want to have a tool like this. So it's a looper, and you basically just put your beads, which are these right here. You want to have beads on hand, as well as a looper tool to help put the beads on your hair, and then use the pliers to close them up. So I don't know if I'm gonna get into all of that stuff on my site. Like, I kind of want to. I don't know. I'm really just, it's a passion project, so we'll see how it goes. If it does well, I'll continue. If it doesn't get a good reception, then, you know, it's just something that I really wanted to do for you guys, because hey guys, so totally spaced and forgot to film an outro to the video. Louie ended up knocking over my camera mid-speech, which I just edited out. But, you know, anyways, if you guys like this video and want me to keep doing hair goal videos, make sure to give me a thumbs up. If you want to check out my shop, you can definitely check the card or either the description box below. If you have questions, leave them in the comment section. I'll be sure to answer them for you guys. And I think that's everything I have. So thank you guys so much for watching.